No problem. We're going to make it step by step.
Okay.
We have the potatoes here. Okay. The potatoes are reheating again. The potatoes are confited. Okay. And olive oil and some herbs. At the same time, I'm going to prepare here the lionfish. Step by step, lionfish is going to be easy to prepare. Just a little bit of water. In a medium temperature, not too high, not too low. Like you see, Juanito, he's turning off the potatoes.
And now he's Juanito.
And now,
Juanito.
Juanito, the best one. The only one.
Parsley?
Yeah. And now, like you see, I'm going to put
the parsley.
The fish fillets. I have one secret here. When I use fish without skin, I need to cook first in this side. Why? Because in this side, between the meat and the skin, you have all the time a little bit of fat. So that's the reason that we cook all the time this part first. So again, just turn this.
So we have to see, look at that.
With this flour, now it's part of the dish. In a few minutes, it's going to create a division between the pan, butter, and fish. It's going to create a crust. But at the same time, at the end, when we create the technique of sauté, that's to recover all the flavors that are going around the pan, this flour is going to give us a texture of the sauce. And this is very interesting when you make this kind of techniques.
So
now I put the excess of flour that I have in the pan, so I can appreciate that the pan is hot in the medium. Otherwise, this becomes dark. I don't want the flour burn here. So one fillet, two fillets, and three fillets.
Well, nice fillets. Good size.
Yes. So now you can smell butter, and these potatoes in this butter are confited. Inside is going to be very soft and tender, but outside you're going to have this nice flavor, and at the same time it's going to be a little bit crispy. It's like you see techniques all the time. From the beginning, for simple dish like a ceviche, Juanito was very technical in every step. The second with the sushi, again, we were very technical. And now here, you can see the right temperature, the right size. Here, that's very good because here, like I said, you can put in a medium temperature or high. And here is very simple. People just follow the instructions. Minimum, low, medium, maximum. So now, I don't want to cook right now. I only want to
stir.
Yes? We have a nice color here. Like I explained in the beginning, I need to properly cool. Now we're going to sear it on the other side. So this potato is almost done.
Chef's bird's idea.
And now it's time for the wine can.
This potato is almost ready.
Yeah.
I'm going to put this fish aboard. Like you see, we all the time we work with technique and soft movements. We don't like to be aggressive when we're cooking. So, like I explained, I'm going to use more butter.
It's very elegant movements, I call it.
And at the same time, I'm going to add this lime juice with segment.
Great.
And it's really good. I have more line segments here that I'm going to reduce. And I'm going to reduce the temperature a little bit.
They look nice.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of work.
And here, like you see, these are nice potatoes.
Yeah.
Fresh lemon juice. We're going to use fresh capers. We're going to have a nice sauce to the combination. Like you see, we are creating a balance between capers, lime juice, and butter here. We're going to add the fresh chopped barley at the end. Not now. Because if I put it in, the fresh barley is going to give us a nice flavor and fresh. And we want it. So you're going to put more lime juice because we have three nice fishes, so we need to have enough sauce. I don't want that you fight for the sauce. Sounds nice, butter. It's a healthy dish, so don't worry.
Butter is all good.
Yeah, and also if you have a good quality of butter,
yeah,
it's perfect.
I believe anything that comes from nature,
mm-hmm,
I eat it.
Yeah.
All the artificial stuff.
Yeah, if you see the French culture, they eat a lot of butter,
and
but they are so healthy because they create a balance. They eat, okay, this fish with
mm-hmm
a nice sauce, with a lot of veggies, very
right,
well cooked, with a salad, like a main course, like a first course, sorry, and at the end, a glass of wine.
Balanced.
It's very, very balanced.
See, the dish is not this big, like in...
Yes,
yeah,
that's right.
It's wine.
Now, you can appreciate the texture of the sauce. It's creamy, and this is very important. I'm going to increase the temperature a little bit more, and also I'm going to add the fish. So this is almost ready. And the good thing is that it smells very good now. So I'm going to accelerate. We can put with a little bit of inclination the fish, and we can start covering the fish and finishing with the sauce. This is a traditional technique of saute. When you finish the protein inside the sauce, first of all, you put all the flavors in the pan. After that, you deglaze. We deglaze now.
Glaze, yeah.
With lime juice, with more butter. And if you see the texture of the sauce,
it's thicker.
Yes. It's like a French they call liaison.
Liaison?
Yes.
Sometimes I have like a flour and you just
add
it as well.
So
one thing here, we didn't put salt in any moment. Now we are going to add salt. We can add salt in different steps. At the beginning, we can put a little bit of salt on the fish. We can put in the sauce, like now we are going to put at the end, or you can put into parts. At the beginning, a little bit, and now in this point, a little bit more, and after that you can try it, and you can say, well, this is good or not, but it's better. Less is more. At the beginning, not too much salt. I'm going to reduce a little bit of temperature now. And again, I want to replace every piece of fish with a sauce. And one of the person also that knows a lot about French cuisine is one. He works at Blue Restaurant. How many years?
Yes, 2 years. Okay. I worked in the when I started the company in the island.
So
I started there.
The fish is almost ready. I'm going to put. I know the fish is ready for experience. But if you want, you can use a thermometer, you can check the inside temperature. And also you can take a small piece and with a knife you can open a little bit and you can check if it's not pink inside. That's good. Now, like I explained before, the chef is in charge to try first. So Juanita is going to in charge to try the sauce, you can use
but
this.
But you don't try the sushi, right? That you don't try? You
no.
Don't
why is this is a good question.
Yeah.
Because in sushi you have the right quantity of salt and sugar in a standard recipe.
So you
first
know
of all you cook the right quantity of rice and you have the right quantity of rice vinegar. So you don't fail.
So that's
you can
the
go
rice.
Yes.
But the tempura? Did you try the tempura? No. Even with the tempura, you know.
Because of the
because
end,
you know everything is already mixed.
All depends on you. All depends on you, that means that you can make that your sushi can be perfect or maybe salty.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because I say all the time, and it's my way. You have this ramekin, but if you put the right quantity of soy sauce, you are going to have a nice experience in the sushi bar.
Right.
But this is not a pool for soy sauce.
Right.
I have a different situations, but most of the people put a lot of soy sauce, it's a pool, and after that they soak it with the piece inside.
Right.
And after they try it, they say, no, the sushi is salty.
Salty. But yeah, I know, because if you dip it in, if you have little, it goes only a certain level.
Yeah.
Smart.
That's good? You approve?
Smart.
If Juanita approves, we're going to put a little bit of almonds.
It's
these
so
almonds
nice with the
are perfectly toasted. So this is going to give us a nice texture. I don't put during the preparation, well this is our choice, because I wanted the almonds are very, very good. And Juanita is in charge to put the small details.
That's
and this is a very nice finishing because now this can be a traditional French style plate. But with the help of these small micros, you can have a nice combination of colors. So then the place becomes, or goes to the next level.